Yo, what is up everybody? How is it going? Clyde here. Welcome back to episode 7 of the Summer ClydeCraft SMP. I hope you guys are enjoying this series so far because today we are going to be building a fully automatic squid farm, and the design that I looked up, I found it's going to give us 9,000 ink sacks per hour. That is insane. So we can get tons of ink sacks, make a shop, sell some ink to folks, and it's just going to be a blast, you guys. Let's get into the video. So I'm going to go ahead and mark out the river biome. It's a little bit tedious because the river actually doesn't need to be over water. So right now you can see I'm plains right there, and even if I go in the water here, it's still actually plain. So I have to go in, and I'm just going to mark out the boundaries of the river biome. Alright, so I just traced out the border of this river biome, and unfortunately it doesn't look like there is an open spot where we're going to be able to find a clean 8x21, and this has got to be the biggest river biome that is nearby, so I don't think anything's going to get much better than this. So what I'm thinking is that even if, you know, this section here kind of cuts into it a little bit, it's not going to hinder too much on the efficiency of the actual farm. You know, if we lose a few squid, that's all right, because I think this thing is going to be pretty efficient. So I'm just going to outline the farm and we'll go from there. All right, this is the outline. We do lose a little bit of efficiency, right? I believe on these two blocks, it is not a river biome. And in this chunk over here, it's not a river biome. But the large majority of this is a river biome. So I think we're going to be getting just fine efficiency, and we're getting tons of ink sacks. The next step is to build nether portals, because we're gonna get the squid to spawn, go through the nether into a killing chamber. So we need a nether portal right here. I think it's every two. We're gonna put them right there and then right there. So we're gonna need a lot of obsidian for this, you guys. However, before we do begin building the nether portals, we have to drain this entire area out. So we're gonna need a whole lot of sand. So I'm going to try to go and get a ton of sand so we can fill this all in. We unfortunately don't have any sponges yet. Maybe I'll ask around, see if anyone has done an ocean monument yet. I don't think so, but I'll give it a try. Alright guys, so I just did a trade with Peter. We got 10 sponges, so that is going to really help us finish out this excavation of the squid farm, because right now filling in with just cobblestone is taking just ages. It's brutal. I've done three sections, I believe. Let's go over and take a look. One, two, three, and I'm working on the fourth, and these sponges should be able to help me wipe that out pretty quickly. We got to dry them, so I'm going to toss some coal in there and we'll get this section finished. Alright guys, I just finished clearing this out. The sponges made this so much easier. It's insane how fast these things can go. So the next step is to kind of clear all this rubble, and then we can actually start building the farm itself. Alright guys, I just finished mining this whole area out. It took a whole lot longer than I thought it would, but that's alright, we're done. The next step is to go get some obsidian to build these portals. We're going to build the maximum possible portals, which is 4 21 by 21 portals. So we need a whole lot of obsidian. Okay, everyone, I just finished up mining 5.5 stacks of obsidian, so this should be enough to make all of our portals for our squid farm. We kind of took down that tower, so I am going to head back up to our squid farm. Alright guys, so the portals are now finished, and the next step is to start building the spawning platforms in between all the portals. We're going to have to go down to the bottom and make glass platforms, because they do need a transparent block to spawn on. It's kind of, you know, simulating a water block, but there's actually going to be glass instead, kind of under the water channels. So we need to go get a whole lot of glass blocks, so let's do that. Bye. Alright, I finally put all the glass in place. I thought it would be a much easier task, but oh my gosh, there is so much glass. That took like, I'm thinking 15 stacks of glass. It doesn't look like any glass at all, but the amount of glass is insane. So, anyways guys, the next step in this farm is to fill in all of these 2x2 high spawning platforms with water source blocks so that the squids can spawn. And this would be actually pretty tough using just a water bucket. That would be just quite tedious. So what we're going to do is go get a bunch of ice, and we can put the ice in there and then break it, and then it'll turn into water. So let's go get a load of ice. Alright guys, I sailed for a little while and I did in fact find a frozen ocean. It looks like someone's already been here and started mining some of the ice. So I'm going to get on this and let's get some ice, you guys. Alright guys, I just finished up over at the icebergs and I got a full inventory of ice. I'm really hoping that this is going to be enough, but so far nothing has been enough for this squid farm. So I'm going to head back and I really am crossing my fingers that I don't have to come back out here. But if I do, I guess I'll have to deal with it. So let's go put some water in. Alright guys, I have some pretty unfortunate news for you all. I was editing this episode and I realized that the footage from the rest of the farm being built has been corrupted and essentially is gone. So there wasn't actually too much, luckily. It was just me putting in the rest of the ice and I kind of just did this voiceover as I'm doing this. But I did it for the rest and then I AFK'd for a little. So I'll throw that footage in to finish off the episode. I hope you guys enjoy. So I just did probably 5 minutes of AFK, super short, just to test out the squid farm so far. So let's hop in the nether and see if we actually got any ink sacs. I spent so much time working on it. And look at that, guys. There's squid in there. So it's clearly working. And oh my, guys, we're actually getting ink sacs. Let's go. If you haven't noticed, I actually had to add another wolf and actually put a cat up on that third one. Because just one boat wasn't working. They were still getting stuck in the portal and they weren't dropping their ink sacs on the hoppers. When they were dying, their ink sacs were going back through the portal. Now it's 100% guarantee when the squid come through the portal, they'll be bumped by these boat with an entity and they will be pushed onto these hoppers and their ink sacs will be dropped into this chest. So guys, I think that's going to wrap it up for today's video. I do have a lot of clearing to do because I want to try to clear out all the rivers nearby because those will take up squid spawns. So I got to drain a bunch of those. But that is probably one of the most difficult farms I've built in a long time. That took a lot of work. But I'm really, really happy with how it turned out. I think we're going to be getting loads of ink sacs. It's going to be just fantastic. So if you enjoyed, go ahead, slam that like button and subscribe. I will see you guys next time. Peace out, everybody. See ya.